through our emotional senses, the devil will play tricks on you. He will constantly make you feel as if God is not listening to you. And I'm talking to people tonight that says, I don't know how to pray as I ought. I don't know how to reach God like that. How do you get into a realm of
Jerusalem? Hey, Cole, come on here.
I was reading the scripture one day. Myron and Don began to talk to me. I was praying about some issues. And it was there that the Lord revealed to me that the only way to be assured that you are in touch with God, you need a problem. You need a problem. And the reason why you need a problem is because problems are designed for internal aggravation. Good Lord have mercy. And see, like King Nebuchadnezzar, if you never had an internal aggravation, something that nobody else can fix, if you've ever been to a place where you are agitated on the inside, and you cannot seem to get an answer for that thing, it is your gift, because it is an internal aggravation that opens up a portal to have you to have the right to be in the presence of the Lord. That's the thing that you contend with that helps you to get into the divine presence of God. When you have a problem, you need an option of prayer first. You don't have anything to take to the master. Then why would you go? Why would you come if you don't have nothing to take to the master? Why would you bother to go? And that's the reason why when I look around society and I see everything that's going on, I get excited in knowing that we are in the end times, and I get excited about the fact that we are about to see the power of God in a way that we've never seen it before. And how do you say that, prophetess? Because we got problems. We got a problem.
that ability, these powers from our people.
Yeah.
In order for us to understand that, Bishop Jordan, we got to understand the fact that the supernatural darkness that God refers to,
come on here, reveal this,
is the spheres.
Yeah.
Wow.
The spheres. Let me work this. The spheres is the realms that is measured in a circular shape around the outskirts of the globe.
That's right.
My God.
Hallelujah.
So in those spheres, you have spiritual endeavors.
My God.
Come on.
You have endeavors that are trying to be projected.
Yes.
Because everything has a space in the spheres. And so there is a race for the space. And so the reason why we see such dominance of the devil is because the people of God have not taken their space. Because we're down here having church, but we have not taken our space. Because in order to take space, you will have to stop lying. In order to take space, you will have to stop fornicating. In order to take space, you will have to talk down your life. In order to take space, I'm not giving about to talk to me. You will have to pray all night long. In order to take space, I'm not giving up. And that's why the devil has no respect for us. The enemy is not challenged by us because he knows the game. And the game is not flesh and blood. The game is space. To do something in attempt to, watch this, to change the course of a goal.
Come on.
Watch this. Eunice using earnest and industrious effect, especially when sustained over a long period of time. In other words, when the enemy is trying to reshape you, it is something that he does over a long period of time. Because the enemy is patient. He's patient. And the reason why he's patient, because unlike us, he wants a permanent result. I'm not kidding, I'm talking to me. The reason why the devil don't make nothing temporary, he's patient. And so he starts working on your life. And he starts working on your life. And he works on you, and he works on you until he has mastered his demonic force in your life. I'm not giving y'all talk back to me. And then it's going to take a real God to get you out. Who am I talking to? And that's why when you see all of these people out here killing 9 people and killing 20 people and walking in a church and telling people, it's because the devil worked on them for a long time. They are now the masters of his work. So why is it that the devil can get people to become masters of his work, but God cannot? Why is it that we serve the enemy full-time, but we serve God on a part-time basis? That they are constant because they are deriving from that which is studied and succumbed to by man.
That's powerful.
I'm going somewhere with this. The more man thinks he has figured out how the earth revolves and all of the effects from it, the more the earth is ran by a spirit of self rather than the humility of God. Which means of the first opportunity its effect will break forth as a set of facts that we see to be a truth but not the truth. Good Lord, have mercy. Oh Jesus. Watch this, watch this, watch this. That which is of the world that does not acknowledge God and submit to his will. That which is of the world that does not acknowledge God and submit to his will is a people that sits in a dark truth that has an end of corruption. Watch this. Because we are not aware of the source from which these truths are derived, we have, watch this, subjected ourselves to praising one God while we serve another. Subjected ourselves to praising one God and serving another. He said the people of God don't understand that to become spiritual is a necessity and not a delicacy. I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. He said to me, look up the book of Daniel and see that when I troubled his spirit with a dream that he could not remember. God said, I wiped the dream out of his mind. And the reason why I wiped it out of his mind, because the people that he was going to call on to help him, they need something to grab a hold to in the spirit realm in order to figure it out. So God said, I had to wipe it out of his mind and I had to keep him troubled. And why? Well, watch this, watch this, watch this. We're going to the reason why. Some things in your life won't go away. We're going to the reason why.